Hi everyone, welcome back or welcome to my channel. My name's Lizzie and today I'm doing a fabric haul and sewing plans video. So I've done a bit of online shopping from the Village Haberdashery. I've been there into their store in person once and it's a gorgeous shop, so if you are London based, do go and have a look. But I did some online shopping this time. Look how cute the packaging is. This is what your fabric will arrive in if you order it online. 10 out of 10 so far. I picked up two woven fabrics and they look like this. I love them so much. Let's start with this one. So this one is, what is it called? I'm gonna hold this up so you can focus on it. It's called Alpine Contours in Dusk and it's like a pale blue, not, it's darker than an eggshell blue, but it's so lovely. Like a cornflower blue? No, it's not cornflower blue either, is it? Not sure what kind of blue it is, but it's lovely and it's got this sort of yellow mountain print on it. I love this colour so much. Pale blue and blue in general suits my sort of colouring and my complexion quite well, so really happy with this one. It's 100% cotton. It wasn't cheap. They sell it in the quarter metre, so it's great if you want to, if you only need a little bit of fabric, or you can be quite specific at how much fabric you want to buy, because you can buy it in the quarter metre. It's £3 a quarter metre. I wanted 2 metres to make sure I had enough for whatever I wanted to make, and so it cost me £24 for 2 metres. I find that quite expensive, but hopefully when I've made it up, I'll, you know, find that it's worth it. The second one that I bought is this one. It's so bold and so bright. I love it. I'm not sure how well my camera will focus on it, but it's bright, bright green with like a navy blue scrawly pattern on it. And this one is from Friedlander and it's called Green Wool in Fern. This one was a bit more expensive. This one was £4 for a quarter metre. So it's £32 for 2 metres, which I think is a lot. I think that's very expensive. But I decided to go for it because I did just love the pattern so much. And let's face it, if you're gonna end up liking the garment that you make, it's all about choosing a really nice fabric you love. So I decided to splash out and treat myself. It's almost my birthday, so that's gonna be my just, actually, by the time you watch this, it might have already been my birthday. Anyway, I decided to treat myself. So the reason I went for these two woven fabrics is because the very next thing in the Love at First Stitch book that I'm working through is the Megan dress, which looks like this. And it calls for a lightweight woven fabric. It also, Tilly has also made a version using like some interlock fabric, but most of the examples she's made seem to be with woven fabric. I thought I'd stick with the trend and not go too off-piste, stuck with my wovens. So now what I need to do is to decide which one to make the Megan dress out of. I'm tempted, I think I'm gonna do this one just because I think this pattern will look really, really lovely and just quite a simple shape of dress, because the Megan dress is quite, it's just a very simple shape. I think it will just look nice in that sort of pattern. But I'm not sure. Do let me know if you think, which one you think I should make the Megan dress out of. Whichever one I don't make the Megan dress out of, I obviously am going to want to make something else. And I've not looked up this pattern yet to see if it is the right sort of fabric, but I'm really tempted to make a sew over it Betty dress. Because I think a woven fabric, you know, obviously it doesn't have very much drape, so it's quite good maybe to make like a, something with a gathered skirt, or you know, a skirt that can kind of, you can create folds but that can just sort of hang quite firmly. Firmly? Fabric doesn't really hang firmly, does it? You know what I mean. Yeah, so I'm thinking with it, whichever fabric I don't use for the Megan dress, I might do a sew over it Betty dress if I've got enough fabric. But I don't think I'd want to make it as long as the full pattern of the Betty dress anyway, because I tend to prefer my dresses a bit shorter. But yeah, the one I don't use for Megan, I want to make kind of a full skirted summer dress, I think. But yeah, please let me know if you have any thoughts on what I could make with the other fabric. So those are the only two fabrics I've bought, but considering it was 50 something pounds in total, that actually makes my eyes water. I can't believe, I'm trying to learn to sew so that I'm like spending less money on my clothes, but whoops, never mind. There'll be extra special dresses that would have cost far more if I'd have bought them from a high street shop, hopefully. But yeah, those are the only fabrics I bought, because I basically rinsed myself in terms of money. But I've got some other plans too, and I want to do a bit of stash busting and also a bit of upcycling. So I've got a few shirts here that are my fiance's, or were my fiance's. He was going to get rid of them and send them to the charity shop, and I thought, hang on, no, let me hold on to them because I want to see if I can make anything out of them. Now, I'm sure you all know, have noticed that gingham is just everywhere this season, and I thought it could be really cute to try and make something out of, particularly this blue checkered one. So I've got a blue checkered one, a purple pinstriped one, and a pink checkered one. But if I'm honest, pink's not really my colour. I think I'm more likely to probably choose the blue. Now, I've done a few sketches. I've not worked out exactly what I want to make. I'm thinking potentially some kind of off-the-shoulder top, maybe with some frill detail, you know, just shove all the trends into one piece. I'll make a gingham off-the-shoulder ruffle top or something like that. So yeah, you might have to kind of stay tuned for a video for when I've actually made something out of this, but that's what I'm planning to do. I'm planning to turn this shirt, or one of these shirts, into a summery top. If you have any ideas, please let me know. I know that, I can never remember exactly how you say her YouTube channel name. Coolipa? I'm not sure, I'll link it below. But she does her thrifted transformation videos, and she's done quite a few transformations using men's shirts. So I think I'll definitely look at her channel for some inspiration, because she's done some really great things. So yeah, that's the next fabric that I'm going to be using. And now for the stash busting. So I've got these gorgeous fabrics here that I've already made one garment out of, and I have tons left. So I've been really racking my brains to try and think what else I want to make out of these fabrics. So this was part of my, this is jersey, this one was part of my Lisbon dress. This one is shirting, and I made my Tilina Buttons Margot pyjamas. This one is Ponte Roma houndstooth that I made, like, hacked a cocoa dress from. And this is some mustard Ponte Roma that I made a cocoa dress from. Now, I want to try and use these to maybe make some summery tops. So I'm thinking definitely with the mustard Ponte Roma, I want to kind of hack the cocoa pattern. So this is what the cocoa pattern looks like, to maybe create a slightly cropped length and add ruffles to the sleeves. Like, I'm just loving the ruffle trend at the moment, but I don't have any clothes with, like, the ruffle sleeves on yet. I haven't bought any, so I want to make some. So I'm thinking with this one, in fact, I've done a few sketches, so that will help me to show you what I mean. Excuse my less than artistic sketches, but I'm thinking of something like this. So I want it to be slightly cropped so I can wear it with high-waisted jeans, probably full-length sleeves just because I'm always cold, but maybe three-quarter length sleeves, and I want it to have a ruffle on the hem and a ruffle on the cuffs. So that's what I'm planning for that one. Again, with Wendy is one of my favourite sewing YouTubers, and she's done a video recently where she adds ruffles to something. So I'm going to use her video to get some inspiration on how to create the ruffles nicely. So that's that one. The shirting, I think it's not very bold in colour, which is what kind of makes me hesitate a little bit with this one, but it's white and blue pinstripes. I'll link you to my other fabric haul video because I've got all the links to what the fabrics are in there. This, again, I'm thinking I want to make something really summery, potentially something off the shoulder, although as I said, I might do the off the shoulder with the blue checks. But again, I've done a few sketches. I'm thinking it doesn't have any drape because it's shirting, so it's quite stiff fabric. So I need to make sure I'm not making something that ought to have drape. But I did think I could make, again, I'm all about the ruffle sleeves, I thought I could make something a bit like this, like some kind of, almost like a smock top with some, like, quite shift shaped, so not particularly fitted, with some wide sleeves with ruffles, three quarter length. That could be really nice, I think, but as I said, I've not completely decided, but that's what I'm thinking. Either that or an off the shoulder top. Then this, I completely don't know. Definitely a top. It's got drape, so it might be with the ruffle, a whole ruffle sleeve thing, like you either kind of want some stiff woven fabric that will really hold the ruffle shape, or maybe you want some drapey fabric to have a floppy ruffle. And I'm quite liking the idea of a floppy ruffle. So again, I might make this into something with ruffles, like some kind of top. Not too sure about this one though, so do make some suggestions if you have any. And this, the houndstooth, I really want to make a skirt out of this one. It is quite thin though, it was brilliant for the Coco dress, but I quite want to make sort of a fitted skirt, and I'm not sure if it's too thin for that. I might need to line it, not sure. But for this one, bear with me while I consult my... I love my bullet journal for like sketching things in. It's so good. Like the grid, but I don't know if you know bullet journal, but the pages are dotty and it's just really easy to like split the page up and do little sketches and things. So I'm thinking of either doing like an A-line skirt, like a high-waisted A-line skirt with a ruffle on the end, or a high-waisted pencil-shaped skirt with a ruffle on the end. As you can tell, the ruffle theme is just going strong. My whole wardrobe is going to be ruffles by the end of the summer because I just love it so much. But I thought it could be so nice because the ruffle would add a playful element, but then it's, you know, it's predominantly black with black, and it's the Girl Charlie coat, like cocoa or coffee houndstooth, so it's not black and white, it's black and like cream, like a dirty cream colour. But the fact that it is basically monochrome means that it can be quite smart. So I just thought like a high-waisted skirt with tucked into a white shirt, or a white shirt tucked into the skirt, like a smart black blazer, could be really smart for work. But then the ruffle on the end just adds a bit of a playful element, because I do struggle with just feeling like I wear really boring clothes to work. And I don't think you need to wear boring clothes to work, but I do work somewhere quite corporate, so I do have to watch it a bit. So... yeah, ruffle hem skirt, either pencil or A-line. Let me know what you think, which one I should do. And then a whole host of summery ruffle tops. Obviously that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 7 different fabrics. So this is definitely, these are long-term goals. I'm not planning to kind of whack these all out in a month or whatever. But I do have a bit of time off work coming up, so yeah, I'm really excited to just spend a really good few days just having a massive sewing binge. As soon as I start to get some of them finished, I'll post a video to show you what they look like. Please do give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. I'd love to hear in the comments what you think, and if you have any suggestions. If you did enjoy this video, do have a look at my channel and maybe subscribe if you'd like to see more of my videos. And yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye!